Alright guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Can everyone hear me and see my screen? Yes, yes, okay, good, good, good. How is everybody? Good, good. Any new people here today? Anyone that hasn't been here before? I can see your voice and hear your screen. Vignesh had some pips today. Good, good. New people, Fabian, Paolo. Hi, Yaha. Yeah. Okay. Michael. Kang, first to this webinar. Okay. Okay, Money, first time in the conference room, but seeing you on YouTube. Okay, so what we're going to do here today is we're going to discuss one of the most critical things in Forex. Okay, if you do not know this, you're not going to make it in Forex. I can guarantee you that. Okay, so it's a very critical thing, and I'm gonna explain to you guys exactly how to do it. Tutorials, tip by tip, everything. I'm going to have you guys do it. And we're going to make it interactive to make sure that everyone's on the same page. And towards the end, we'll go through questions and answers or any repeats that you guys need me to do. The webinar is going to be approximately 1 hour long. And yes, this will be on YouTube as well. For those of you who are watching this on YouTube, please make sure to comment and like right below the video. And let's get started. Let's get started here. Now, what is support and resistance? What does support and resistance mean? Let's get into that first. A theory of support and resistance. Walls, very good. Okay, it's nothing but a wall. Okay, now, if I have a 2x4, a wall, can you break through it? Yes. Okay. What if I have a 1-inch concrete wall? Can you break through it? If you're good at kung fu. Yes. If I have a 20-inch concrete wall, can you break through that? Okay. You see how the things go, that yes, you can break through these things, but you need more and more strength. Okay, that is the very basis of support and resistance. Don't think because a support and resistance line is there means that, oh, by God, nobody can move this area, like the market's going to return from here. No, it doesn't work like that. Need volume, echoes. Is everyone's can hear me fine or any issues? Okay, Y for yes if everyone's okay. I should reduce my volume. Just reduce your volume on your computers, yeah. If it's too loud or anything. Okay. So seems to be, okay, distorted voice. Okay, for those of you who are having audio issues, you guys can pretty much log out real quick and log back in, see if that solves the issue, but seems to be working for the majority here. Okay, so let's get started here. Okay, so going back to the concept, support and resistance is a wall. And just because it's a wall, it does not mean it cannot be broken. Okay, depending on how thick the wall is, it needs that much force. Okay, that's the basic concept. You need to understand this. Okay, because a wall is there doesn't mean anything. Okay, it means it can be broken. Now, how do you draw support resistance? Here's the good part. How many of you know how to draw support resistance? Well, you guys answer that. I'm going to have some of this. Okay. Me, yes, yes. Okay, we had a few people saying yes. We don't have that speed of people saying yes on this. Draw only from a big candle. I'm learning. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk on how to draw your support and resistance properly. Okay, many of you guys have you guys heard of pivot points? Okay, how are pivot points calculated? Pivot points are basically yesterday's average. How are they calculated? High and low, okay. It takes all the information from yesterday, okay? And then it calculates it and it gives you pivot points. Now, here's the thing. How many of you guys have the exact same screens in terms of your charts? They're exactly pip to pip. Okay, chances are almost nobody in this room has the same charts. Okay, yes, they have the same, you know, the movements, yes, but it's not the same chart. People have a variance of server time, which is the reason when you plot your pivot points or any other indicators for a matter of fact, you have a variation. Okay, even if you can get the time the same, it does not mean you have the same level. It can also mean you can be off by a certain level, certain pips, because the price that fluctuated on my screen is not the same as the price that fluctuated on your screen. Okay, it can range from broker to broker, and even if you're using the same broker as me or anybody else, it can also range from demo to live. That can also make a difference there. Remember, brokers have the ability to move price slightly, of course. Okay, because that's the spread they can move based on the price they get. Okay, some brokers have a very good feed, and the prices are pretty accurate. Some don't, which means the prices tend to not fluctuate too much. So that's the thing. Now, coming to that question, so everyone's pivot points, you know, pivot points are really powerful. Don't get me wrong, but pivot points have this issue of timing. You know, the timing have this issue, and you can sit here and cry about it and look for a server time day and night, but at the end of the day, what pivot points basically are, they're nothing but support and resistance. Okay, so let's get into this. Now, what is support and resistance? Is this area here a resistance right here? Yes. Okay, this is a resistance, you know. This is where the market touched and bounced from. Okay, is this area here a support? Okay, anything above the market is called resistance. Anything below the market is called support. Okay, now that being said, let's take a look at the next things. Now, how do you know if a support and resistance is strong or not? Okay. Check the past data, multiple touches. Yes, multiple tests. Here's the thing. Take a look. On this particular day, the market moved up. It stopped here and then it went down, right? So if I actually put my line here, and I can see here what happened here, it never held. So what I'm trying to say is there is different levels of support and resistance, and what I'm going to teach you guys is what's most important. Okay, I can teach you guys a small support and resistance, but that's useless. You know, trust me, throw it out the window. You know, it's useless. I'm going to teach you guys how to spot the strongest support and resistance for your day. Okay, this is what's going to make or break your trading day. Okay, now, a support and resistance level should be a level that has been used again and again and again. Okay? Now, we had an area here. The market came all the way down till here. If I put my line here, the market comes down, it continues, and then we have this big thing. What is this right here? Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's a big red candle. Now, what this big red candle did is it's just telling you one piece of information. It's not telling you to close all your longs and run away. No, no, no. It's telling you one piece of information and one piece of information only. It says we just broke a strong level. This is the reason why it needed more force to break through. Remember that concept in the beginning I asked you guys. Any level can be broken, but it depends on how much force is needed. Okay, this is bigger than the average candle here. That means this must have been a strong area. How do we know? Because in the near future, it holds the market. And what do you know? After that, it again required a lot of force to break through it. So this level has some level of strength. This is a strong area. Okay? Now, you guys understand this concept, right? Of being a strong area. Now, what I'm going to explain to you guys is you might be asking me, how come you put your line here on this tail here and over here you didn't put the line on the tail? What's going on here? You know? Let me explain to you. When you draw your support and resistance, okay? When you draw your support resistance, there's two things you need to measure. One is the body, and the next thing is the tail. Okay? Here's why. You cover the entire range when you do that. Now, if I put my line here on the lowest body, is there a single body that closes outside of this? No, not a single body that goes outside of this. Okay? Tails are fine. Tails are just trying to tell you that it tried to go out, but it couldn't. So tail, you can have as many tails as you want. It doesn't mean anything. It's the bodies that make a difference. Now, if I draw my line here, and I also consider the tail, did this big candle break through both these levels? Yes. When time comes into the near future, did this level here hold the market in? Also, yes. So when you trade support resistance, do not trade a single line. People are looking for pinpoint entries, not happening. This is your pinpoint entry. It's a range. Okay? Now, then the market crosses above it. Did this big candle break through both of these yellow lines? Yes. Okay? And then this level goes on and then it halts here. You can see big tails coming out, breaks through, and then uses this as resistance. Take a look. Look how it struggles at this area and then just drops. Okay? So this happens again and again in the market, time after time after time. All you need to know is where to draw your levels. Now, there is a strategy that goes behind all of this, and I'm not going to go into the strategy part of it. We're going to do maybe another webinar on a support resistance strategy. It's very, very powerful. But right now, all we're going to do is we're going to discuss drawing the support resistance properly, because this is very, very critical. If you can do this, you've already gone 50% of your battle of making it in Forex. I can promise you that. Okay, now, moving forward. Now, take a look at this. If I draw my area here on the body, is there any bodies coming above here? Okay, no. And then I take my tail also. Okay, we have this area here now, right? Now this big candle that broke through, look how big this candle is. Do you think this area is quite strong? Okay, how do we know? Let's go back even further. Let's see, what is this area? Oh, well, what do you know? It's held the market in the past, and it's only used a big candle to break through. Let's go further back. Okay, let's see if there's any more market that goes here. Okay, big candle breaks through again. Anything else? Oh, look, a little touch over there. And this goes on and on and on, you know. So I can't express this more, that you need to draw your ranges. Now, let's go back to the area where we had that big candle break. Where'd it go? There we go. So we had this big candle break. Now we have this little zone here that's strong. Okay? The market continues and it continues north. Okay? Did it ever come back down here? No. Will it come back down in the future? Maybe. All we know is we can use this area possibly when the market actually comes to it. Okay? Now the fact is we have, what do you know? We have another big candle, which means something else has been broken that was strong. Let's move our lines. I put my line here on the body first. What is the highest body possible? Here we go. And then I cover the highest tail. And then I confirm, has the big candle broken through both lines? In this particular case, yes. Okay. We move forward. No touches yet. Okay. Ah. Well, what do you know? It's like magic. Okay. The market tends to respect these levels again and again and again. Okay. It will respect it. Now, it came here with a big strong candle and then it retraced. Okay. Now, yes, I've been up. That's good. Now, there's one rule of support resistance. When you have a level of resistance, now here it was above the market, it's resistance. And if it breaks through, your resistance now becomes support. Okay? So in this particular case, it became support. It was halted here. Then the market struggled here for a bit. It broke, it went long, really strong. Bounced off of which area? There is a body here, which covers this area, which covers this big candle. Okay. What about the tail? Let's cover the tail. Okay, we got this area. Well, what do you know? It held the market once again. And it held it over here again. You see how it, this is the reason why the people generally draw this line here at the tip. They're like, this is your support. No, no, you need to take both your body to your tip. You need to take your range, because when you take your body to your tip, you take factors that you don't see, such as this one. Okay, and over here, you're taking these bodies. And here, you're taking a pinpoint here. Okay, and then these levels get respected again and again. Take a look here. The market bounces off of here. It goes long and it crashes through. Big candle, which means lots of force. Okay, lots of force going through. Now this area, that means, is strong. This is no joke over here. We've had one big candle, two big candles, three big candles. And this area has been respected again and again. This is more powerful than the one below it, because the one below it has some whipsaws here. Okay? It's going in and out a little bit. It's not respecting it as well. It respects it, but not so well. So we know that between both of these, the one on top is more strong. Okay? So we go further and we see the market comes crashing down, it goes through it, uses it as resistance, and then it starts to go sideways. Okay? Now, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna pick pairs. Okay, I'm gonna leave it to you guys. We're gonna pick a pair, we're gonna pick a date, and we're gonna do the support resistance to it, and then we're gonna scroll forward and I'm gonna show you how the level has actually held. Okay? So somebody give me a pair. Okay, pound. Okay, give me a date. Yesterday? Okay, yesterday. Or let's use a random date. 10-1, there we go. October 1st. Okay, so pound October 1st. Okay, so we go to pound right here. And I'm going to scroll as fast as I can so I don't see the market. We're going to go to October 1st. Where is my lovely October? Wait, did we not? Okay, November, October. Okay, there we go. We're in September now. So we want to do October 1st. Are we predicting for October 1st or do you want me to draw on October 1st? What do you guys want? Predict. Okay, so we're going to do it one day before October 1st. What was the last day of September? Was it 31st? Okay, let's see. 28 September. Okay, there we go. 28 September, last day, right here. Okay. This is the last trading day. Now, I'm looking at this screen. I haven't seen October 1st. I need to know what I need to be ready for on October 1st. Okay, October 1st is going to come along and I don't know what to do. Okay, so all I know is I have a certain level of information, couple things I can work with. I have this big candle I'm working with, okay, huge level. So I'm going to draw my lines based on this huge level. I'm going to be like, okay, this level has been broken, and this level holds here, 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 all those areas. Okay, so couple things. I'm going to take this area and this tail. Okay, which tail is better? Is it this tail? Does it look right over here? Which tail should I use? Lower, the red one, right? Okay, now does it make sense, this area? Okay, you see how sharp it is here. Okay, plus the entire red thing has broken through this entire, both of these lines. So. It is a big range. It's 89 to 65. It's like 90 to 65, 25 pips range. So we have this little range here now that we're working with. Now, has this range held true in the past? Let's take a look. In the near past, a little bit of whipsaw. Okay, it's held here, but it's held here, over here not so well, but over here it holds. Take a look at this area. It holds there just fine. We go further back. The bottom one holds just fine. So, okay. This level has some decent amount of strength. Okay. I'm not coming up with these levels. These are levels what the charts are showing us. So, we come back to the 28th of September. And we're going to discuss one thing. Is this the strongest level of the day? Sorry. Is this the strongest level of the day? How much history do you need to validate? You don't need much history. As long as you can check and see there is support and resistance from a certain level, you're good. Okay. Now, is this the strongest level? Let's see. What if we use this area on top here? And we use this tail. Okay. We're holding this area in. That's fine. We're holding this area in the past. That's fine. Okay, we have a big candle breaking this area. Perfect also. We're holding this entire market here. We're holding this entire market here. Missed by a few pips here, that's fine. We're holding the market here. Pinpoint here. Okay, so we have a level up here too. But which one looks better to you? The top one or the bottom one? That's the question. Which one looks more ideal? Okay, lower one? Okay, so we're going to stick to the lower one. Okay, half of you guys are saying top and some of you guys are saying lower. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to stick to both of them. We're going to keep both ranges. There is no harm done. We can keep both ranges to understand what the market might do. So let's see. Okay, 28 September, we draw on our areas. Okay, do we need an area down here? Do you think we'll have support resistance? We only see support, right? Probably not resistance in the immediate past. So October 1st comes along. Markets move. Ah. Touch number one. Pinpoint. It's moving on. We went down a little bit. Okay. Maybe we got a few pips here and there. That's fine. Okay. Touch number two. Okay. Remember, whenever you see this, refer to your candlestick patterns. Does this candle tell you it's going to go down? Does this candle tell you it's going to go down? Refer to these patterns. Do you understand these? Okay. The only thing that you need to think of is, do I have my strong support and resistance? That's step number one. Step number two, once you draw your support resistance zone, there's only thing that's going to happen here is you have the perfect spot to take a trade. Either you're going to take it long or you're going to take it short. There's a 50-50% chance on your side. What you do from here is based on your analysis. But this is the spot to trade, because if it wants to break through this level, it has to be a big candle, obviously, because there's a lot of pressure needed. Or if it returns from here, you've taken the optimal price. So what is there to lose? You know? So you're going here and you see this area here and you're like, okay, touch number two. Maybe it looks short. I check through my correlation. Possible short. Let's see. Ah, what do you know? It drops again. Okay, cool. And that is your 1st of October. You've had two entries. Is everyone with me so far? Is everyone understanding how this is working? Okay, do you take short trades all the time here? No, not all the time. Okay. Raj, so how do you plan to trade from here? No, the trading strategy of this, I'm going to get into it in a different webinar. Right now, what I need you guys to do is perfect this method. Perfect the method to draw them, okay? Once you draw them, we can talk about making the pips later, because if you're really trying to make the pips now, you wouldn't be here in this webinar if you're really focused on making the pips and you've already learned something. You're here for a reason. You're here to learn. Let's get that done first, and we'll worry about the pips later. Okay, so best time frames for this, 1 hour. Okay, 1 hour is my favorite. It gives you a better view of multiple days. Yes, you can use 4 hours and daily, because when you do it on a higher time frame, you can see more days into the past. You know, here, like when we draw these things, we saw what, 3-4 days almost in one shot, you know, so it gives you a better view, a better glance. Okay, somebody pick a day. Today? Okay, we can do today. That's fine. Okay, so today, what pair? Gold, okay, we'll check gold and EU, okay? Euro, USD, and gold. We'll do both of these. Okay, so Euro, USD today. Today is what, the 23rd, right? So I'm going to go to 22nd. Where is 22nd? So, because whenever I show you guys my screen into the future, you guys have this tendency to go with what the market says and not what you guys think. So let's focus on this thing right now. Okay, so this is all the information do we have. Where do I draw my line? Take a look at your charts on your own screens and give me a number, all of you guys. Where do I draw a line? Give me one area only. Let's check 3320. 3320. Close. Until 3333. No, I wouldn't go with this area quite yet. Okay, 3323. 3285. 3285. Where's 3285? 3285. No. why 3285 is wrong is it's the low. Where is your resistance to this? It's only support, no resistance. Okay, it's a strong area, don't get me wrong. It's a very strong area. Okay. But we want the most strongest area. What is something that actually looks at you and says, no, I'm going to hold you down over here. You cannot pass me. We want something really strong like that. Okay. Mark Sander is 3400 is all the way up here. Is that number correct? Okay, so all of you guys have this number, right? Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw my numbers and you guys are going to test it with your numbers and see if it's correct. We're going to do several of these. So draw a line on your screen and then I'm going to draw a line on my screen and you guys check. Is it the right one? Okay, I'm going to give you guys 30 seconds. Okay, when you guys are ready, after you've drawn your lines, where is my poll? There we go. Oops. Okay, whenever you guys are done and you're ready, you let me know. You just use this poll to tell me that you've drawn your lines on your screen, and then I continue onto my screen. The moment we touch more than 70%, we will continue. Okay, yes. We have 60 some people in the room right now. 63, I think. Yeah, 63. Yeah, 68. I want at least 40 people saying yes over here, so before we continue. So draw the lines on your screen and then compare them to mine. All right. We're reaching about 30, which is half the people. Okay, 30 is fine too. Are we going with top of wicks or top of bodies? I want both. Draw the lines on your screen and then compare them to mine. It's just a glass of water, FX. I just had a bottle of wine. So. Okay, let's begin here. Okay, we got the 29 and we hit 30, we continue 30. There we go. Okay, let's go. Let's do this. Okay, so here we go now. We have these areas. First things first. If I draw my body here, does it break through a big candle? Yes. We have one big candle here. Okay. Support, 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 and resistance. Remember, look at this big tail that's coming out. It had struggle time over here. Okay. So let's take this tail. Okay. Now I've taken this tail. Does this cover this area, this area, this area, this area, this area? And whenever it's been broken, does this big candle break through both? Yes. Okay, these big candles break through both. This green one right here? Yes. We have a range here, 3342 and 3331. Okay, now what have you guys said down here? Let's check this down here area. We've had this support right here. This is the first area. And we're gonna take the tail also. Do we cover this entire area here? Yes. Right? Remember, bodies are important. That's why I'm using this area and not this one. Because if I put my line here, then I'm not covering this body. Bodies are important. Let me cover this body. And then I'm going to take this tail. Now I have everything covered. So I have this entire area covered. Now we're going to go back with this bottom line. We're going to go back in time a little bit. Does it hold? Yes. Okay, holds as support again and again and again. Big candle breaks. Strong area. Ah, we have resistance also. Right? And big candle break. So, we have these two areas that are strong. Okay, top one, possibly, because it's holding again and again and again. Which one is stronger? Okay. You guys are saying same, support, top. Okay, so let's take a look. Let's say the market moves on, right? Market moves on. Today is, what, 23rd January. 22nd was finished, 23rd began. We began with our mindset that this is the areas we want to trade from. Otherwise, I am on a vacation. Otherwise, you know, I'm not doing anything else. So we're waiting. The markets are moving and voila. First touch. Second touch. Third touch. Did we cross? No. It held the market. Markets went long. Okay. How far long? First touch. Oh, wrong button. Okay, do we go short here? I don't know. I mean, how strong do you think this candle is? Over here, we have some indications to go long because we're getting big tails telling you that there's a lot of pressure pushing it north. But we come here and we have this big, massive green candle. It's barbaric. It's really scary, you know? So you're like, will it go north? I don't know. Let's wait another candle. So we wait another candle. And now it's showing you signs that it might slow down. Okay. So we have some chances that it may turn around from here. Okay. Another sign here. Third in the third touch. And, well, what do you know? We're having a big candle break right now as we speak. So, are we long now? We're long. This is long for the rest of the day now. Because even if it comes back, it's going to bounce from this area and go long. Otherwise, it's going to have a big candle break through. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to trade this at 80 lots, you know? I'm going to go long with this sucker. Once, whenever it executes, apparently even demos can open large amount of lots. Very good point, Hassan. The candle hasn't closed yet. Yes, that is very true. Should always wait for a candle to close, okay, to understand the movement. Now the thing is that, why am I taking this long? Okay, let's check. Let's first check. I'm going to show you why. Once this executes first. See how the brokers don't want me to make money on my demo? Yeah, so as this executes, I'm gonna give you guys an example. I'm gonna, what? Trade time data. Okay, let me lower the lot sizes. Let me see if, I don't wanna waste our demo money. Yeah, I'm buying at market, Chris. Let's see. Let it execute first, and then we can continue. Yeah, I'm waiting. Trade timed out. Ah, of course. I'm on my VPN. Okay, I'm gonna turn off my VPN. If I get disconnected, I'll be right back. I don't think I will. Okay, there we go. So now we have a trade. Can everyone still hear me and see my screen? Yeah, stupid VPN. Okay. So now we have this trade ready. Now, I've taken this long for a particular reason. Reason number one, we start from here. We've had this massive strength starting from here. Big tails and everything coming out. Now, next thing. What does the last candle indicate? Okay, that's pretty much a trend continuation, but not too clear, right? Not too clear. It's not that clear. Okay, next thing. If we're going to break through this area, it's no joke to break through this area. You need a strong candle to break through, especially if you're going to start over here. You have a long ways to go, you know? So you need some strength to break through this area. Now, next thing. Based on the last candle, let's take a look at correlation. Which pairs correlate with Euro USD? Give me the pairs. Pound. Okay, let's take a look at pound. Based on last candle. What does the last candle tell you? Does it tell you long? Tells you, in fact, it tells you it's a trend continuation pattern for a short, but it tells you that the short is running out of steam. There's a big tail coming out. Okay, so the next candle opened up, it went all the way down till here, and now it's headed long. Okay, we still don't know if it's gonna go long. What's the next correlating pair? You guys said euro yen. Okay, let's take a look at euro yen. Ah, last candle. What does the last candle tell you? What kind of pattern is this? Trend continuation long. Euro yen already tells you it wants to go long. Okay. What else? Let's take a look at New Zealand dollar. Last candle. Okay, New Zealand dollar tells you otherwise. It tells you short. Okay, eye on New Zealand dollar. What about Aussie dollar? Does Aussie dollar correlate? Aussie dollar also is telling you short. Now, how do we know if Aussie dollar and New Zealand dollar are correlated with Euro USD? Let's take a look. Today, the market on Aussie dollar went down, then up, then down. Euro USD today, down, then up, no down. Okay, could be slight off correlation. New Zealand dollar, slightly down, then up, then down. Now, here's another thing to look at New Zealand dollar. We have this area here. If we take the bodies into consideration, we have an area here. And tails. We might need a big candle to break through this to go long. So we have issues right here. And then finally, we had Swiss franc. Last candle also tells you that it's not ready to go short. So was this a good decision for me to go long right now? No, not really, no. Good. Yeah. You should wait till you have confirmation. Okay? You should wait till you have confirmation. In this particular trade, it still looks like it's going to go long. I'm not too worried about that, but what I'm trying to train you guys is wait for your confirmations. Okay? Wait for your confirmations, because once the candle closes, that's step number one. Or two, check your correlation first. The least you can do is check your correlating pairs and find out, is it actually getting ready to go long? In our particular case, only what Swiss franc was the only one that said, I'm going short. Or not Swiss franc, what was it? Euro yen. Yeah, euro yen was the only one. that gave you the heads up. Everybody else is like a little lagging behind. Yeah, correlation is off a little bit lately. So, if the market comes back down and closes here, then what do we know for this information? We could very well be possibly short.
Yes.
Okay, more examples. Now, we're going to leave this running. Give me a pair and give me a date. Try to keep away from the current dates because everyone has seen the current chart. Let's try to go back in time so you guys can draw your support and resistance properly. Would you kindly remind us how to ID the leading pair? Yeah, in this particular case, if you take a look at, was it Euro-Yen? Euro-Yen was the first pair to actually tell you it wants to go long because not even in this candle, the last candle tells you that it wants to go long. So Euro-Yen being the leading pair. Now Euro-USD needs a lot of steam to go out of this area. So we wait and see. So far it's pretty big candle. Okay, CAD, January 15th. Okay, CAD, January 15th. Let's take a look. January 15th. Okay. We're down here to 8, 9, 10, 11, 14. Okay. 14th January for CAD. Okay. Draw your lines on your screen, and once you're ready, let me reopen this. Hold on. How do I clear this? One second. Prepare. Open. Okay. Once you're ready, click yes, and then we'll take it from there. Draw the lines on your screen for US dollar CAD for 14th January. Draw your lines there. We're going to predict 15th of January. Okay, we need at least 30 people for me to continue. So draw them on your screen. And then we can compare them with the ones I draw. And the rest of you who do not want to do this exercise, I hope you guys are enjoying the webinar and it's informative. Good. Like I said, this is a very, very important part of trading. Very important part. If you miss support resistance, you will not make it in Forex. I don't care how many emails you guys sent me saying that statement is wrong. Bring me any mentor in the world to tell me this. If you do not know support and resistance, you will not make it. Can draw on screen or web browser? No. I meant to say draw on your charts. Manny, the charts keep coming back to current day. What you do is you click on this icon here. This icon basically auto scrolls. Yeah. Okay, we have 18 people, 20. Okay, we're gonna give it another 10 more seconds and then I'm gonna begin. Money, you're on FXCM's, I think, trade station it's called. It's no problem. Just look at my screen and try to get a visual idea of where it might be. That's okay. Okay, Money, you're welcome. Okay, here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, let's get started here. Okay, perfect. 30 people just in time. Shri, yes, this webinar is recorded. Now, and if you're watching this on YouTube, again, please comment and please like. Okay, I won't take no for an answer. All right, here we go. On this particular one, let's take a look. What are the areas that use as support and as resistance and are crossed by big candles? First things first. For me, what looks to me is I have an area here. Okay, that's one area. Let's consider this body also so we can cover everything. Okay, we've got this body. Now we've covered this body. We've got some of this area. Okay, now let's take the tail for it. Okay, now do we have all bodies covered? Okay, we have the body here covered, we have the bodies here covered, and we have the bodies here covered. Area number one. Let's check area number two. Do we see anything else? Yes, oui. We have our body here, which respects this area. Big candle break, respects this area. Okay. Let's draw the other side of it is here. Okay, so we have these two areas, these top two lines, these bottom two lines. Which one is powerful? Let's take a look. Let's take a look. Lost connection. It's recorded, don't worry, Dennis. You can always watch it back. But so which two areas are powerful? Now the top one so far has been stronger. It's been holding. But let's take a look. The top one holds again and again and again and again. Big candles up and down. Bottom one holds here. Moving back. Top one holds. Big candle break again. Again, again, again. Bottom one holds. Top one. Big candle break again. Holds. Big candle break to the bottom. Bottom one holds. Which one is good? Bottom one or top one? Bottom one. Big candle break. Both for me. Okay, here's the thing. If you say it's the top one, check yes. If you say it's the bottom one, check no on the poll. How do you determine which one is good? The one that, well, actually, you're trying to cheat, huh? Wait, hold on. Let's let the polls come out and then I'll get you the answer. Yeah, I'll explain to you, Murray. It's actually quite simple. I'll explain the concept. But let's first try to find out what does the average person guess for this. Okay, so we have majority of people saying the top one. Okay, here's the thing. Now, how many times has the top one been crossed by big candles? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... Hey, wait, what day was, what were we doing? US dollar CAD for which day? 15 January, okay, so we did 14 January, okay. So the top one, we've had more levels of breaks on both lines with the big candle. The bottom ones, we've had how many? One. And this whole time we had one. Just one. So the top one tends to be stronger. So all 31 of you guys correct. Okay, Murray, did that answer your question? Which one is good? Like, does that make sense? Okay, cool. All right, now going to 15th of January. Let's go candle by candle, little by little. Okay, moving. Okay, we're going down from the bottom. Okay, first touch. Okay. This candle indicates a possible short. Let's say you short. Okay, you made some money there. Market grows, it surges past. Okay, goes long now, bounces off there. Okay, we have a small tail. Now you still are assuming that we're gonna go long here. Okay, so you wait for confirmation. Then it drops. Okay? Respects that area. And then a big candle break to break through this area. And the market then continues to drop. Uses this area as resistance. Same thing that's probably currently going to happen on Euro-USD. It's turning around. But if you were to assume this is the stronger area, you can either work with this area, wait for this to confirm, and then go. You can come to this area, check your correlation, see if there's anything there, and then go. Again, there is a strategy around this. I'm going to get you guys a strategy later. Right now, I want to make sure everyone knows how to draw this. That's the primary key. How many of you guys draw this correctly, these four lines or two lines? Okay, one, no. Okay, no, not at all. Okay, so then we need to do more examples. So let's not waste time. Let's do some more examples. Okay, also do the bottom size, got the bottom, just the bottom. Okay, so let's do some more examples. Let me delete all this. Let's take a look at our beloved Euro-USD that's dying. This is today's trades. Where we go? Okay, $3,000 down.
Yikes.
Okay. All right, Chris, I'm lost. Okay, this will help you out. And also try to rewatch the video on YouTube. And watch it as many times as you guys need to try to understand. Okay, pick a day. Any day. January 19th. Okay, what currency? Wait, there is no 19th. There is no 19th. This is 18th. 19th is like a Saturday. Okay, Euro Yen, 2nd December. Okay, let's take a look at Euro Yen, 2nd December. Euro Yen. Man. Okay, Euro Yen currently is headed long. Okay, so we might have some chances for our Euro USD. Okay, Euro Yen, 2nd December. Let's take a look. Let's reach our 1st December so we know where we're going. 26, 27, 28, and 29. There's 29 November. 30th. And wait, there is no 2nd December also. You guys are just giving me Saturdays and Sundays. Okay. Pick another day and currency. We're gonna do this quickly. January 4th. Okay, you guys, you've been trying to want for gold. Let's take a look at gold. 10th January gold. Let's take a look at gold. Okay, same concepts applies for gold also. Let me turn this off. Okay. 4, 7, 8, 9. Is the next one 10? Yes, the next one's 10. Okay. Here we go. Now, we have all this information on our screen until 9th of January. And we're trying to predict what's going to happen for 10th of January, right? So let me close this. We're trying to predict what's going to happen for 10th of January. So I come to this point and I'm like, okay, first things first. Where is there an area that uses both support and resistance and is crossed by a big candle? You want all of this information together. Okay? So, is this a resistance right here? Okay? Yes, it is a resistance, but it's useless. Okay? What are you going to do with this? It's nothing. Okay? But is it a resistance? Yes. Okay? So, let's get rid of that one. Now, we want to find one that is strong. Okay, that's the whole point. Finding one that it's going to take not only you, but it's going to take even the market a really strong candle to break through it. Okay, so I'm going to draw from here. I'm going to draw my big line here. Okay, well, does this look about right? I just drew one line so far. Okay, it holds here. 165294, 165219 should be correct actually. Money, don't worry. So we've holded this area, big candle break, holds, holds. Now we take the tail. We take the tail and we're covering the bodies and we're covering the bodies here. So all good, everything is set. Here we don't cover the bodies. So we need to move it slightly lower. Okay, now we're using this tail. So now we've covered everything. There's no bodies pending. Everything's sexy. Okay? We have this little tight range, 1653 to 1651. Okay, is there anything else that we spot? Okay, Michael, you can go back as far as you want. Like, we've drawn on this 3 days, right? We can check back and be like, has it held? Okay, yeah, it's held here also. We can go further back and be like, okay, it's held here. Go further back, okay, it's held here. Big candles coming out of it. Go further back, okay, it's held here. It's held here as resistance. Beautiful. You know, it just keeps holding again and again and again. Okay, so, but had that being said, we want to check also, wait, again, I'm lost. What day were we checking this for again? Gold for what day? 10th January. Okay, so we're on to 9th. Right? Yeah, that's right. That makes about sense. Okay, so the next thing, we want to check this level on the bottom here. We have these big candles coming out. What is this bottom area? Let's check. So let me put my candle here. Oh, right there. And let me take the tail over here. So yes, we cover this area. Let's go further back. Okay, we cover this. Big candle breaks. Okay, let's check the bottom one. Okay, yes, it holds here. A little bit of whipsaw here. Take a look. Which one do you like so far? Okay, top one. Top one seems to have a little bit more sense. Can we use pivot points as support resistance? Chris, yes, you can. However, with pivot points, you will have a small variation. Okay, we were on 9th of January, yeah. 9th Jan. And so we're going to go with the top one, as most of you guys like the top one. And we'll take it from there. Okay, so here comes 10th January. We're moving candle by candle. Well, we never touched. What do you know? You're just chilling. Okay, now the next day, this is the closest thing we can see. Okay, we got our bodies in place, we got this area in place. It's the closest thing we can see the next day. Big candle break. Okay. Now these ranges actually go from here now. Okay. So it's the same concept applies through all charts, whether it's gold, it's futures, it's anything. If there is a level that's strong, you will need a big candle to break through. The bodies within means they've been contained. Yes. Because that they're in the zone that they're bouncing off of, right? Yeah. Yeah, the traditional one line of support resistance is, again, useless. So a lot of the things that is taught in the market is actually nonsense, because what happens if it was actually good, 90% of the people wouldn't be losing. You know, that it's, but people need to understand the very basics of things. Why it, what is a MACD? What is an RSI? They're all the same thing. Okay? They're all the same thing. What if predictions go wrong? Then you have a losing trade. I mean, you cannot expect everything to be perfect, right? You have some bad trades. It's just the nature of trading. Okay? And when it goes wrong like this. You see how you have a big candle flying through? So you have to keep your exits ready. Okay? All comes down to psychology. Yes, it definitely does. Psychology is a very big part of it. That's we're gonna do a webinar on psychology as well. If you haven't already done so, we have one already on YouTube. It's called What You Need Is Mom, M-O-M, which is Mind Over Money. Okay, correct ID for support resistance candle formation. So yeah, so I hope all of you guys are members at urbanforex.com. Here's a new news that's coming up. The internship training program that we've had at Urban Forex, we've discussed it with everybody. The basic program we're opening up for free for everybody. The intermediate program is going to be now $99. So those of you who have already paid, you guys are covered for the intermediate program. We might even give you some access to the Forex Watchers while you wait for the intermediate. So in the meantime, if the rest of you guys, if you guys still need some more extra education or training, we're available at forexwatchers.com for advanced training also. I think there should be some promotions going on there as well. So yeah, there's lots to learn. We have weekly webinars here at Urban Forex as well. Lots to learn here. Internship is already started. It's just a training program. And if we find someone useful, we'll also hire them. So it's whoever graduates from our training program also gets a chance to be hired. Okay, yeah, we've redesigned the internship program. It's really, really cool now. It's we have animation in there and we have some cartoons and everything. So how about the ones that paid for both? You guys will get some access to Forex Watchers as well. So those of you who have already paid will get some access to Forex Watchers. Those of you, for the rest of you guys, we're giving you open access to the basic training. I am the one. I do not see the lessons updated very long. Yes, we have up to week 3 for now. Week 4 should be released in about a week's time. So just hang in there. We just redesigned everything, so things are falling into place now. For those of you who do not know, Sardar, Abhinav, and Sunshine are our support writers as well for this. So whenever you guys see them on the webinars or chat rooms, please do thank them for their time and support. Okay, Naveen, sorry to go off topic. Is the last webinar, I think it was 4th of January. I took short. Should I still stay short? Oh, Jackson, I don't remember the last webinar from 4th of January. How do we get access to Forex Watchers if we have paid for the internship? Get in touch with Samira, which is on info@forexwatchers.com. Let us know the email address you used with PayPal, and we'll get you your access. Okay, last webinar is not on YouTube yet. Yeah, I'm really, really bad with putting my stuff on YouTube quickly. So it will be up there. This one's going to be up there quickly. I'm going to put this up as this is very critical. And then last week we had Urban Towers. We'll put that in as well. Umesh, no, it's not the same login. It's going to be different. I'm going to create accesses for you guys. Okay, it's just a temporary access. You guys will get like a few weeks or so, like we've mentioned earlier. So this was only available for the first 150 signups. So I think that's already full. So yeah. Thank you all for attending. Dennis, what about your trade on EURUSD? Did you? Oh yeah. Sorry, I forgot about the trade on EURUSD. No, it's still running. The reason why it's still running, EURUSD/EURYEN. This is why. Take a look at this current candle. Looking good. So Euro USD is still running for me. Oops. Okay, now at 2,000. So again, if it wants to break through, it needs to break through strong. If it cannot break through strong, it's not going. It's not going anywhere. It's coming back down. Okay. I know you don't use stop loss, but what's to be ideal pips amount for stop loss? I'm going to do one more. When I do a webinar on money management, we'll discuss how I do my stop losses. Because I don't use stop losses. And there's many, many reasons why. Okay. It's not to go against all the books and stuff. Because honestly, if you're reading a book of somebody, why aren't they trading? So, anyways. Yeah, that's about it. It's 8:39 p.m. from my time, and it's 7:39 a.m. New York City time. I'm going to go ahead and close the webinar now, and thank you all for attending. I really appreciate it. There was a pretty decent-sized people in the room now. And yes, well, any one more question? Sure. What's the question? And please do help support if you guys can. Do purchase your subscriptions at forexwatchers.com. And also, that's about it. Do purchase your subscription at forexwatchers.com. That is the more advanced area. Okay, we teach all of this stuff and more. In time, we do release this information to Urban Forex. But if you want to learn everything now, then Forex Watchers is the way to go. That is my forecasting company. Okay, is correlation back to normal? No, it's not back to normal. Okay, have a good dinner. Thank you. Alert group, we're going to do a webinar on MP, market profile, which is going to go closely with auction market theory and some of the techniques I teach. So that's going to be quite good. So, all right, that's about it for now. So do you trade on a moving candle, right? I do trade on a moving candle if I am certain of certain things. We can also go over that sometimes. So, Murray, when the leading pair hits the blue zones, you enter the other pairs, yes? When I actually have more than two pairs, actually, Murray, not just one. All right, guys, take care. Have a wonderful night. Bye-bye now.